Hi, my name is Dylan Bennett. I'm going to show you PICO-8. It's a fantastic game engine for what I like to call delightful game development. Basically, PICO-8 is like an emulator for a console that never existed. I'll show you how it works. This is the code editor where you write all of your code for your game. This is the sprite editor where you draw all the pictures and art for your game. You only get these 16 colors, and that's it. We'll come back to this. This is the map editor. If your game has a map, you can use the sprites you've created as map tiles for your game. This is the sound editor. It's super easy to use. You just draw the sounds you want for your game like this. You can also have different instruments you use like this. And if you're musically inclined, you can switch to what's called tracker mode and see the actual notes that make up the sound. From here, you can do things like change the transition between the notes. And lastly, you have the music editor here, where you can use the sounds you created in the sound editor as tracks for your music. But let's go back to the code editor. PICO-8 has three core functions you can use to control the flow of the game. You have init, which happens at the very beginning of the game. You have update, which happens 30 times a second. And then you have draw, which also happens 30 times a second, but happens after update. So let's say in draw, we have it clear the screen every frame. The whole screen is just 128 pixels by 128 pixels, so let's have it draw a pixel right in the center. Using a command called pset, we say how far over and how far down, and then what color. And remember, we only get 16 colors, so let's pick one, say 12 for blue. Now we run this, boom, there it is. Nothing special, but it works. Back in the code, let's make this easier to change. So up in init, let's add x equals 64 and y equals 64. Now, for pset, we can just say x and y. When we run it, it still does the same thing, but it works. But now we can go in the update function and listen for button presses. So if we say button left, then x minus equals 1. And if button right, then x plus equals 1. And if button up, then y minus equals 1. And if button down, then y plus equals 1. Now when we run it, look at that. We can drive around our pixel. So easy. But let's say we want to have a little character running around instead of just a pixel. So we'll go into our sprite editor and let's make one. So there we go. Now notice we drew this in sprite number 1. We have lots of sprites to choose from, but this happens to be in number 1. So if we go back to our code, instead of drawing a pixel at x and y, we can say draw sprite number 1 at x and y. And now when we run it, boom, we have a character running around the screen. You can see how easy it is to get up and running with PICO-8. Now what if we want to add sound to this? We just go to our sound editor and we can draw sound. Then we can change the volume so it fades off, and now listen. Look at that, we have a coin sound. Let's add it to our game. So if we go in the update and we say, if they press button, say X, then play sound effect 0. And we run it. Look how easy that is. But now let's make our game really cool by adding a map. If we go in the sprite editor, you'll see we have no map tiles, so let's make some. Now that we have some map tiles, let's go add them to our map. Look at that. We've got a cool map. That looks awesome. Let's go into our code and add it. So now, after we clear the screen, let's draw the map starting from map tile 00. Now when we run it, look at that! Our character's got a whole map to run around on. How cool is that? We've seen how easy it is to get up and running, but what about sharing your game with others? I mean, that's the whole point of making them, right? I love how easy PICO-8 makes it to share what you create. Before we do that, let's add a title to our game. Maybe, My Cool Game by Dylan. And then let's run it, and let's hit the F7 key, and notice it said it captured a label image. Now when I go to the command line, I can type save my game, and then we're going to say .png, and watch what happens. You see that? It created a game cartridge of our game. This PNG image is our game. It has everything. This one PNG image has all the code, all the sprites, all the map data, all the music, all the sounds. It's all right there inside that PNG file. And I can just share that PNG file with anyone. I can post it on a website, I can email it to someone, and then they have my whole game, all of it. How cool is that? But that's still not even the coolest part. See, if I give someone this game cartridge, they still have to have PICO-8 in order to run it. What if I want anyone to play my game, even if they don't have PICO-8? Simple, watch this. I just type export mygame.html, and boom, it exports an HTML5 version of my game that can run in the browser. Check it out. I just open up that HTML file, load it in the browser, and look at this. It's a whole copy of my game that runs inside the browser, just like in PICO-8. And down here, I can even go full screen too if I want to give them the full experience. How cool is that, right? And I still haven't shown you the coolest part. One of the greatest things about PICO-8 is the amazing community of culture and sharing and collaboration it has. And that's built right into PICO-8. If you use this feature called Splore, you can see all these other amazing things that people have been creating with PICO-8. And you can just pick one and load it up, like this one, for example. And boom, right here, I can play this game that someone else created. And then, if I decide, you know what, I actually want to see this for myself, and I can go in here, I can look at all the code that was used to create that game, and I can see all the sprites that were used. Here's the map data, the sound, all the music. And for instance, in the map, I can go here and say, I want to change this up a bit and make this a little bit different. And then when I run it, there it is. I just changed the game myself. And I can go back into the code and I can learn from what this person did to create their game so that I can make my games better. I love this. At this point, I hope you now understand why I refer to PICO-8 as delightful game development. You can just go to pico-8.com and get it from there. It really is a wonderful environment to create in, and I hope you will join me. Thank you for watching.